안녕하세요, 여러분. So today we are going to film outside, but as you can see, 오늘 날씨가 나빠요. 비가 와요. 바람이 불어요. So we're gonna do it inside instead. But first, I want to show you something because as you remember, in the previous video, my husband mentioned that he's into farming these days, one of his hobbies. I just want to show you, we haven't planted any seed recently. It's really from last year, but look. So if I recall correctly, this is called Minari. So yes, we have some babies, some sprouts coming out. So that means it's spring. 봄이 시작했어. Yo. 봄이 시작했어요. It's really chilly and because of the rain and humidity. So let's head inside, please, quick. So to make different from other videos where we film mostly in the dining room, now we decided to do things differently. We're gonna film in the kitchen. So I thought, why not introduce the kitchen a bit? So here it is. We moved in, I think, in 2021. So it has been already around three years. We decided to go in black and white concept. At the design stage, we decided to consult my mom because my mom loves to put her touch into everything, and I think she's good at interior design, so she helped us with the choice of this cabinet. So yeah, the top ones are white, the bottom ones are black, make a really contrast, white counters.
그럼 저희가 저번 영상에서 얘기했던 한국으로 가는 그거를 계속해서 얘기를 해보자면 Why Korea, baby?
Why Korea? Because you're from there.
That's obvious. But it's like, if we go to Korea, basically I'm going back to Korea.
You're repatriating. Mm-hmm.
But yeah. For you, it's gonna be like to immigrate.
Yeah, we are reversing the roles. Basically. Why am I on board? My experience in Korea has been very, very limited. The longest I've been there was for 3 months as mm-hmm. a student living under your parents' roof. I have not experienced life of someone that has a routine such as working. And I've been told when you immigrate somewhere, you go through a honeymoon phase where you feel a bit like when you travel, you discover a new place, surprised by everything, and everything seems nice. I think it's normal that as humans, we love to sometimes go out of our comfort zone and experience something different than our everyday life. But when you start to live there and you are installed and you start to work, and everything that you hated to do in your home country, basically, sleep, public transit, work, sleep, public transit, work. Oh wow, like I want to live there because oh my god, that seems amazing. Nah, nah, nah. I cannot rely on my 3 months. However, I can say that according to the testimony of friends, my friend that you have seen in one of the videos, Semi, she has lived in Korea for 2 years-ish. Around 2 years. And she has been outside of the honeymoon phase. She worked there, she had a routine, so her point of view is different. And I have read online about the experience of other foreigners living in Korea. And I know the country is not perfect. Mm-hmm. I know it will sound weird, but what attracts me a lot is the healthcare system. This is one of the weaknesses of Canada, let's be honest. To be honest, I feel really safe in Korea. But even in Korea, as a woman, walking alone during the night, I felt relatively safe. I think I also like appreciate the behavior of people in public transit. People are more disciplined, I think, in general. Mm. I don't want to generalize, say, all Koreans are like this, but from what I have also heard from other people, in general, people in East Asian countries, so we're talking about Korea, Japan, mm-hmm. are not individualistic. They are more thinking about my behavior should not disrespect other people around me. So people not talk loud on the phone. My point is basically people are well behaved, so when I take public transit, there's no like super loud people or people that disturbs other people and random people that talk to you and make you feel like uncomfortable. It is a country that I am very open to live in. Of course there is that slight worry about being homesick because it's normal. It's not not like if we were moving to United States where the difference between United States and Canada is not that big. Now we are talking about a culture gap, and let's be honest, I am going to be a minority there. Of course, people will not treat me the same as if I was Korean or even East Asian, because depending where you're from, your appearance, if you are able to kind of blend into the crowd, but me, no matter where I'm gonna be going, I'm gonna be, you know, perceived as the foreigner, the outsider. But that, I can deal with it. I mean, haven't experienced it here, so.
Mm-hmm. The things you've talked about is more about a comparison between Korea and Canada, right? Let's talk about your thoughts, how you made your decision, right? Because like, for me, like, I've been through already, like moving from Korea to Canada, leaving everything behind, like my friends and my family, everything. Basically, like, I think people would wonder how you came up with moving to another totally new environment, like just like that, you know?
I think I have told you, even like from a very long time, I was always attracted to other cultures, other country. I feel I am someone that wants to live new experiences. I think it's just in human nature to think that grass is always greener, the other side of the fence. I think we all think like that. Especially that now we live in an era where people can move, not compared to like a century ago where you were basically stuck where you were. People have choice, more control of their lives. Even before meeting Aaron, my life has been, I don't want to say boring, but like, okay, like I'm ready to move on. I'm ready to live something else, live somewhere else.
So you're looking for more adventures in your life? Is that it?
What I mean adventure doesn't mean doing something crazy, but just immigrating somewhere else, expatriating. For me, it's an adventure. It's,
of course,
the beginning of a new chapter in the book of your life, you know? Mm-hmm. So maybe it's a midlife crisis, but
I think for me, living in Korea was like first phase of my life, and
obviously
in Canada be like second phase, and third, it's gonna be
going
another life Korea.
But let's specify this, your life in Korea in 3 years is going to be very different from your life before.
Exactly.
And also very different from the life you would have if you have stayed in Korea all your life. And also, like, we are married, because your life would have been different if you were, let's say, married to another Korean woman versus me. Our plans. Hmm? People are probably gonna wonder, what the hell are we gonna do in Korea?
I think once we move to Korea, we're gonna stay in my parents' place for a bit, and then probably we're gonna start traveling all of the places in Korea to find out the exact spot.
Yeah!
For the rest of our life, I would say.
Yes, seriously, I really loved when we went there to do like some road trips and go outside of big cities, because I was so impressed by everything. I was like, oh look, Bibe, oh, like traditional architecture, look at that church, it's like so like traditional architecture, and for me it's so different, and I just want to experience more the outside of the big city. Mm-hmm.
Ideally for myself, I wanna live in a like small village near the sea and then just enjoy the life over there. But you says at some point you're a city girl.
I am a city girl.
So I wonder if you'd be okay living in a small village near the sea, like kind of like middle of nowhere.
But like I said, Korea things are more close to each other. Hmm. So if I feel like, oh my gosh, like I need to go to a city to do more stuff, first of all, you guys have like a very good train system, and it doesn't have to be Seoul, can go just to the nearest city, even though it's not like biggest city, just to, you know, experience a bit more, like do more stuff over a weekend, or I'm not worrying for that.
So our plan is to, for a year, we're gonna travel South Korea, all over the place, and then find the exact spot for ourselves, and then just settle there, just live happy. Yeah, basically our plan is to have enough asset to cover our living expense, which we are gonna make in Canada until we actually move. And also, like, I don't think we've found a job that we really enjoy the most, or we really enjoy to do.
It's,
I think, hard. We are just working for
survival.
Survival, right? So I think we're gonna have plenty of time in Korea. Our ultimate goal is gonna be to find, I don't wanna say job, but like things that you really enjoy the most.
I mean, of course we're not gonna sit on our butt and do nothing. Like, I want to draw webtoons. I have a lot of story ideas and it's just I don't have the time to increase my skills in drawing. The drawings that we've shown on the channel are the very simple, because like the mascot Tasha is like very simple design. But you've seen my more elaborated drawing.
Okay, we can show you like at some point, I guess.
I have to finish some drawings first, because they are all work in progresses at this point.
The main point of being fire is to obtain more times and then just live your life based on your desire rather than
survival
or chasing for money.
Because let's be honest, a lot of jobs that people want to do related to their hobbies like art or music, highly competitive, and the people that are able to make a living out of it, it's a small portion. So at least when you are in that movement, at least your living expenses is already covered, everything is already settled, so you can do it more for fun. And if you're successful and make money out of it, good. But what matters the most is having the time to do it for your own enjoyment. I think it's so important. Well, what about you? What made you want to repatriate?
I think the biggest reason is my family.
Oh, but we. Obviously.
제가 한국을 가고자 하는 이유는 단순해요. 부모님이랑 더 시간을 보내기 위해서거든요. 왜냐하면 이제 사람들은 망각의 동물이고 후회를 많이 하잖아요. 요즘은 아무리 뭐 100세 시대라고 하지만 저희 부모님 세대가 이제 앞으로 인생을 살아봤자 한 3, 40년 정도지 않을까 싶어요. 그래서 저도 이제 해외 생활을 앞으로 2026년도에 저희가 이제 한국을 가게 되면은 외국 생활은 한 10년 정도 딱 채울 것 같아요. 물론 부모님들은 제가 어렸을 때 키우면서 했던 게 이제 다 추억이겠죠. 그리고 그 기억들이 아직까지 남아있고. 근데 이제 저 같은 경우는 뭐 어렸을 때 기억이 이렇게 많지가 않아요. 뭐 예전에 뭐 부모님이 이렇게 사진을 찍어서 앨범으로 보관했던 그런 걸 봤을 때 그거를 보면서 이제 잠깐 기억한다고 생각을 하겠죠. 그렇기 때문에 이제 저 같은 경우는 부모님이랑 추억을 이제 사진으로밖에 기억을 못하는 건데, 이제 많은 사람들은 부모님 밑에서 자라다가 이제 독립을 하면서 이제 자기 인생을 살아가기 때문에 바빠지죠, 많이. 그리고 이제 애까지 낳게 되면은 내 인생 살기 바빠서 이제 부모님이랑 어떻게 보면 더 추억을 만들기도 힘들 거고. 그래서 저는 파이어족을 되겠다고 생각했던 이유도 이제 부모님이랑 더 뭔가 재밌는 추억을 만들고 싶거든요. 앞으로 뭐 부모님이 계속 늙어가고, 그리고 앞으로 이제 재밌는 시간을 만들어가는 그런 기간이 어떻게 보면 한정적이잖아요. 그리고 뭐 많은 어른들이랑 이제 얘기를 했을 때는 다들 그렇게 얘기를 하는 것 같아요. 부모님이 돌아가시면서 나는 할 만큼 다 했어. 내가 효도를 할 만큼 다 했어. 임종을 끝까지 못 지킨 그런 분들도 있고, 그러면서 어떻게 보면 다 후회를 하는 거잖아요. 그래서 저는 그렇게 나중에 후회할 게 명확하게 보이기 때문에 그 후회를 안 하려면 어떻게 해야 될지 되게 많이 고민을 했었거든요. 그래서 일단 가장 큰 문제점은 이제 내 인생을 먼저, 그러니까 내 노후를 먼저 해결해 놓으면은 이제 돈을 이제 조금 덜 걱정하면서 어떻게 보면 이제 좀 더 많은 시간을 만들고 그 시간을 더 활용할 수가 있는 거겠죠. 그 시간을 이제 부모님이 돌아가시 전까지 더 많은 추억을 만들고 싶거든요. 그래서 나중에 이제 뭐 뻔하게 있을 그런 후회거리를 안 만들기 위해서 가는 겁니다. 물론 이건 제 계획인데, 만약에 부모님이 야 너는 그냥 너 인생 살아라, 나는 우리끼리 더 재미있는 추억을 만들겠다, 그럼 뭐 할 말은 없어요. 근데 하지만 캐나다 계속 살면은 뭐 1년에 한 번 정도 보는 거니까 뭐 어찌됐든 한국에 가게 되면 1년에 한 번 보는 것보다 더 많은 시간을 보낼 수 있는 거겠죠. 그래서 이거는 뭐 제가 뭐 부모님을 강요할 수는 없는 부분이고, 그래서 부모님도 이 부분에 동의를 하면은 좀 더 가까이 살면서 더 재밌는 시간을 보낼 수 있는 거겠죠. 어떻게 보면 영상을 보시는 분들은 저한테 뭐 이기적이다 이렇게 얘기하실 수도 있을 것 같아요. 왜냐면은 와이프는 이제 가족들이 캐나다에 있는데 저는 이제 와이프만 데리고 한국을 가는 거기 때문에 그 부분도 어떻게 보면은 이제 저희가 시간을 잘 활용해서 중간중간에 캐나다를 놀러 오거나 아니면 와이프 가족들을 한국에 초청해서 더 많은 또 재밌는 추억거리를 만들 수 있지 않을까 싶어요. 저는 2016년에 이제 이민을 가겠다고 결정을 하고 이제 부모님한테 말을 했었거든요. 그 당시 부모님은 굉장히 많이 반대를 했었어요, 이민 가는 거에 대해서. 그 당시 저는 이제 취업도 일찍 했었고 괜찮은 회사에 다니면서 이제 돈을 벌기 시작했고, 주변의 친구들은 아직까지도 취업을 못했던 친구들이 많았기 때문에 그 당시 부모님은 지금도 괜찮은데 왜 굳이 이민을 가려고 하느냐, 많이 반대를 하셨었어요. 근데 그 당시에 저는 어떻게 보면 이기적이었던 거죠. 이제 좀 더 나은 인생을 살고 싶었기 때문에 반대도 무릅쓰고 강행을 해서 캐나다에 오게 됐고, 근데 또 와서 또 괜찮게 사는 모습을 이제 부모님한테 보여드렸으니까 부모님도 나름 만족을 하시는 것 같은데, 그래서 그때는 그 이기적인 그런 결정을 했었지만 이제 앞으로는 부모님을 위해서 뭔가 좀 더 제 시간을 투자를 하고 많은 추억을 만들고 싶어요.
Alright, so now it's time to wrap things up. We've pretty much covered most things that we wanted to cover. This is a big summary of why we have decided to go live in Korea later. If any of you watching is having hard time to cope with daily routine or expectations of life and the system, I know it sounds pretty deep. I just want to give you like just a bit of hope. To tell you like it's never too late to take control of your life, and especially I am aware that not everybody has the same life circumstances and not everybody has a privilege to do it. I this is something that I acknowledge. For those people that know that you could do it, we deeply encourage you. I think yes, we are encourage everybody to empower themselves and take control of their life. If you want to share about yourself, have a work in progress in terms of plans or immigration plans or expatriation plans or anything really, you can share in the comment. I think it's really inspiring to see everybody's goals and projects. We are in our 30s, we are in a point of our life that we are deeply ingrained into the routine and working our butt off to live, but we decided to turn things around. And whether you're in your 20s, your 30s, your 40s, you can do it. I hope you have enjoyed this video. I know there are some heavy topics in there, like existential crisis and having regrets. But still, we hope you have enjoyed it. And we will meet you in the next videos. As usual, I am telling you, au revoir.